Do you want to build your own robots with ROS? Today I'm going to show you 5 things that you need before you get started. If you're watching this, then you've probably heard of ROS and you want to know how you can use it to make your own robots. If you don't know, ROS is a series of open source tools, libraries and frameworks to make developing robots easier. By sharing the code that they have in common, developers are able to focus on coming up with new ideas and technologies. These new designs are then ROS compatible, which lets the whole industry solve problems together, faster and better. There are so many different kinds of robots out there, but this video is going to be the first in a short series that focuses on some of the core things that you need to know before you get started, no matter what kind of robot you're wanting to build. So today, before we dive in and install ROS, we're going to cover 5 things that you need before you get started. The right skills, the right computing hardware, the right operating system, some other useful software and other useful tools. Making robots with ROS requires a certain set of skills. These include computer administration, so installing operating systems, configuring networks, familiarity with Linux, being able to install programs, create files and folders, that sort of thing, familiarity with Git or another version control system, a basic understanding of programming and building code. We won't be writing too much code ourselves, but we will need to be compiling code written by others, and some basic electronics experience, so things like using a breadboard, soldering, or programming an Arduino. Now, some of you might be thinking, oh, I don't have all these skills. I'm never going to be able to build a robot. But the great thing about the internet is that it is full of resources on how to do all of these things. So have a crack, give it a go, and if you get stuck, take a look online and you'll be able to find help. The next thing we'll need is obviously a computer. Now, getting the computer right can sometimes be a tricky part of robotics. You see, we want a computer that is powerful enough to run our algorithms, small and low energy enough to fit on a small battery-powered robot, and cheap, because who doesn't like things being cheap? This is especially true during development. We often need extra computing power so that we can run prototype versions of algorithms, debuggers, visualizations, simulation environments, sometimes all at the same time. Now, the way that we're going to try and tackle this problem in an effective and affordable way is to split it up into 2 computers. The robot itself will have a small single board computer on board, in this case, a Raspberry Pi. And that will be paired with a larger off-board computer that will act as a base station and a development machine. This machine will just be a pretty typical mid-range laptop or desktop. Using ROS, the Pi can take the raw sensor data, transmit it over the network to the base station. The base station can perform the appropriate calculations, send the results back over the network to the Pi, which can then send signals to the motors and whatever else to do what the robot needs to do. As well as running the algorithm, the base station will provide a visualization, it can receive joystick input, and it will double as a development machine for us to write the code on. Now, if you know what you're doing, you could tweak this setup. You might want to use a Jetson instead, or you might want to split the development and the base station machines into 2 separate PCs. However, I'm going to be using this setup in these tutorials because I think it is simple and effective. Now, although we'll eventually be running the Pi without a screen because it will be inside a robot, during this setup procedure, I'll be assuming that both machines have access to keyboard, mouse, monitor, power, and internet. Now, I know some of you out there are going to have some questions, so before you start asking them in the comments, do I need a super high-end gaming rig in order to start developing robots with ROS? No! Although if you're using an older machine, you might find that you need to tweak the parameters of some of the algorithms and the simulation environment might run a bit slowly. I'd recommend any kind of mid-range machine, something with an i5 from the last few years would be fine. Can I use a virtual machine or a Docker container instead of doing a full installation? Yes. Ish. If you know what you're doing, virtual machines and Docker containers can be a really useful tool for ROS development. However, they can be pretty fiddly to set up. If that's something that you're comfortable doing, then go for it, but just be prepared to deal with any hiccups that might come up along the way. Personally, I'd recommend that you do a full installation. I don't have a Raspberry Pi or other robot hardware. Can I still learn how to make robots with ROS? Definitely. Wherever possible, it's best to first develop your robot inside a simulation environment anyway. So there's nothing stopping you from going ahead, doing these tutorials, learning ROS inside the simulation environment, and then down the track, you can go out and purchase whatever hardware you need to build an actual robot. Now that we've got the right hardware, we need to install the right operating system. Now, each version of ROS is compatible with a particular release of Ubuntu. For these tutorials, we're going to be using the latest long-term support release of ROS 2, that's called Foxy Fitzroy, and that's compatible with the latest long-term support release of Ubuntu, which is 2004 Focal Fossa. So you're going to need to go ahead and install that on both the base station slash dev machine, as well as on the Pi. Now, I'll be using the Ubuntu Mate installation. It's available for both x86 64 and ARM 64. Make sure you get the 64-bit versions of both. And I'll include links to download them in the description. Now that we've got our operating system installed, we need to install some extra software that we're going to use for development. The three pieces of software that we're going to install are Git, VS Code, and the Arduino IDE. First up, Git. Git is a very popular version control software. We're going to use it to synchronize our code between our two machines, as well as keep it backed up. So the way we install Git is to simply type sudo apt install git. And we're going to want to install Git on both the Pi and the dev machine. Next up is VS Code. VS Code is an advanced code editor, and it's what we're going to be using to edit our code. So to install that, we go sudo snap install classic code. We only need to install code on the dev machine. You can install it on the Pi as well if you'd like, but it's a bit more of a hassle and we don't really need it. If you already have your own favorite version control system or editor, feel free to use them, but this is what I'll be using in these tutorials. I also highly recommend installing the VS Code Remote Development Extension. We don't need it, but it makes it much easier to write code on the Pi once the screen's no longer attached. The third piece of software that we're going to install is the Arduino IDE. Now, you can install it on either or both machines. It doesn't really matter. It's a bit more straightforward to install it on the development machine. However, that means you're going to have to plug and unplug USB cables every time you want to program an Arduino. So I'm going to install it on both. Finally, there are some other tools that I recommend having in your arsenal as we get ready to build robots. This is by no means a complete list, but some of the things that might come in handy are a 12-volt bench power supply, a battery charger, a multimeter, a soldering iron and solder, various crimp tools and their connectors, various screwdrivers, various wire strippers and pliers, a rotary tool, a 3D printer, a portable keyboard, mouse or screen, and various fasteners and adhesives, like cable ties, screws, bolts, tape, etc. You definitely don't need all of these things, but some of them will come in handy as you go about making robots. One last bonus thing you need is the right attitude. Working on robotics projects can sometimes be pretty challenging and it's tempting to give up, but it's worth it to push through and be able to make something that works the way you want it to make and does the things you want it to do. And you'll learn plenty of skills along the way. So if you get stuck, look around online, get some help and keep going. So those are the five-ish things that you'll need to start building robots with ROS. If you have any other ideas, let us all know in the comments. If you found this video helpful or interesting and you want to learn more about robotics, please like and subscribe for more of this stuff. In the next video, we're going to take a look at how to get our network set up correctly. And then after that, we're going to install ROS. So see you then.